with we are going to start a new poem on his blindness. This poem has been composed by a famous English poet, John Milton. This is a sonnet. Do you remember what sonnet is? I have told you last year. Sonnet is a poem which has only 14 lines. सोनेट क्या होता है जो हैविंग 14 लाइंस. सोनेट में क्या होता है, केवल 14 लाइन होती है. एंड दिस इज अ मिल्टोनिक सोनेट एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो अ पर्सनल सोनेट. व्हाट इज पर्सनल सोनेट? दिस इज अ पर्सनल सोनेट ऑफ मिल्टन. Personal sonnet means the poem in which the poet shares his personal feelings. He is present in the lines of the poem. He does not take the help of any other imagined character. Here he is telling us about his personal experiences, about his personal feelings. Milton became blind, and what did he feel then? How helpless he was, and he is making complaint to God for making him blind. But ultimately, he realizes that God is always our well-wisher. He never does anything wrong to us. So we should surrender ourselves to the will of God. This is the best service to God. In this poem, we feel the great faith of poet in God. Let us start reciting the poem. When I consider how my light is spent ere half my days in this dark world and wide, and that one talent which is death to hide lost with me useless, though my soul more bent to serve there with my maker and present my true account, lest he returning chide. Doth God exact day labor, light denied? I fondly ask, but patience to prevent that murmur soon replies, God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. Who best bear his mild yoke, they serve him best. His estate is kingly, thousands at his bidding speed, and post over land and ocean without rest, they also serve who only stand and wait. When I consider how my life is spent, consider means think. When I think, the poet says, whenever he considers, considers means thinks. Okay. Whenever he thinks how my light is spent, light here means eyesight. Light means here, it means eyesight. The poet says, whenever he thinks about how he has been deprived of his eyesight. Spent means he has been deprived of. Ere half my days. Ere means before. Half my days means half of my life span. In those days, average human life was supposed to be 100 years. And Milton became blind before 50. So he says, more than half of my life is still to live, but he has been become blind. He has been made blind. So how he is going to spend rest of his life in this dark world and wide? Due to blindness, the whole world has become dark for him. Suppose you imagine yourself for some minutes, close your eyes. Everything will become black. You can't move. one or two step. So in this dark world, now the world has become wider for him because he has become blind. An average man, a man with eyesight, can walk properly. He can go anywhere easily. But if you close your eyes, it will become very difficult for you to cover that very distance in the same time. You may fall. You may break your bones. But for the poet, the whole world has become full of darkness. It has become bigger than it is. And that one talent, which is death. And that one talent, the poet has been blessed with one talent by God. And what is that talent? To compose poem. Each and every one has been given something or other by God. Here the poet has been blessed with the talent of composing poems, composing poetry. And the poet says that, that one talent, which is death to man. His talent is lying unused, and as soon as he dies, his talent will also die. Why? Because it has not been used by him. Lost with me, useless. It is lying useless. If you don't make use of your talent, nobody will know about you. And the moment you die, your talent will also die. Though my soul more bent to serve there with my maker. Maker is written with capital letter. Who is maker of the whole world, the whole universe, and each and everything? God. So the poet says, though means although. My soul more bent. My soul from the innermost heart. I wish to utilize that talent in the service of God who has given me this talent. Means God has given me talent of composing poem, and I want to compose some great poetry in his praise. But I am helpless. Why? Because I have become blind. To serve there with my maker. The poet says he wants to serve his maker. The poet wants to serve God with his poetic talent and present my true account. He wants to present his good account to God after his death. Human being or any living thing is mortal. Someday or other, everyone will die. So the poet says, when he will die, he wants to show his true account to God. My true account, lest he return each other. So that God might not rebuke him, God might not scold him. Returning child means, when he returns to God, God should not scold him, God should not rebuke him for not utilizing his poetic talent. Here is a biblical story. Once a master goes out and he gives his servants coin. Means there were three servants and he gives one coin to each one and asks him to utilize according to their skill. The two of them utilized it in business and they doubled that money. But the third one did nothing. He kept it safe in fear of losing it. And when his master came, two of them returned with profit, but he returned the same coin. So his master rebuked him for not utilizing it, for not increasing the money. Here the poet relates himself to the third servant. He says that just as the master scolded that third servant for not utilizing the coin, in the same way, God might not scold me, rebuke me for not utilizing. realizing my talent, but in my heart I want to utilize it in praise of God. That God exactly labor like that, but he has a complaint to God. He says that death God exact day labor night. God has made day and night. Day is supposed to work hard and night is to take rest. And for the poet, all 24 hours have become night. How can a person work during night? For him, the whole day is night, the night is night. So he is asking question to God, if he has made him blind, how can he expect him, how can he hope from him that he can utilize his talent? I fondly ask. He is asking question to God like a foolish man, but he is getting no answer. He is feeling very sad. He is very, very dissatisfied in his heart for his helplessness. He wants to do, but he is unable to do anything. But patience to prevent that murmur soon replies, God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. But patience to prevent that murmur soon replies. But patience to prevent that murmur soon replies. Which figure of speech has been used in this slide? But patience to prevent that murmur soon replies. Patience means the feeling of tolerance. There. Prevent means to check, to control. That complaining voice soon replies, answers. So patience is an abstract idea. Here the poet has personified it. He is using it just as a human being who is answering to his question. So which figure of speech has been used here? Patience has been personified. So this figure of speech is personification. What's the figure of speech, bachcho? Personification. So the poet says that patience, the feeling of tolerance, controls his dissatisfaction, controls his complaints, and says that God doth not need either man's work or his own. God does not need either man's work or his own. God has given us so many things. He doesn't want anything in return. It is a human tendency that they expect something in return, but God does not want anything for his gifts, because he has given us uncountable things. We cannot return him. So we should not think about that. God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. And God is omnipotent. He does not need our service. He can do anything with the blink of his eye. He doesn't need our service. Who best bear him mild yoke, they serve him best. And his patience tells him that the person who surrenders himself totally to the desire of God, he is the best servant. What does it mean? Means if we are face to face with misfortunes, with hardships in our life, we should accept it as the will of God, and we should not complain to God for giving us misfortune. And this is the best service. Means if we have full faith in God's decision, this is the best service to God. And God wants nothing from any one of us. His state is kingly. Means God is the King of Kings. The whole universe is His state. His state is not a small state. His state is kingly. He is the Lord of Lords. He rules over the whole universe. Thousands at His bidding stream. Thousands, innumerable, uncountable. Uncountable people are in His service. They don't want to any service from He doesn't want any service from us. So let us surrender ourselves to the will of God. Thousands at His bidding speed and post over land and ocean without rest. They also serve only stand and wait. So the people who only wait for the order of God, for the desire of God, they are the best servant of God. So many people, so many good things are waiting for Him. In the last line, the poet says that they also serve who only stand. They, who are they? The people who are suffering. They should wait for the next decision of God and they should serve Him. They should wait for His next decision and serve Him faithfully, and they should never complain. I think the poem is clear to you. If anything is not clear, you can ask me. The last 6 lines. The patient to prevent that farmer soon replies, God doth not need save, they also serve who only stand and wait. It's very important for explanation. So please prepare it and learn the central idea also. Okay, bachcho. We shall meet in the next class. Bye.